Hi, welcome to Sand Mountain Community Watch. We appreciate you tuning in today. Today is Tuesday. What day? March.
What day is it, March?
March the 21st. I'm doing good to know the month. So we were off
2016.
Last
2016.
No, it's not. It's 17.
I was just testing.
Yeah, well, so today is March 21st, 2017, and we're glad to be back. We missed out last week. I had to have sinus surgery, and it's not been pleasant. It's not the worst thing I've ever went through, but it's not fun at all. And for some odd reason, there was something up. My sinuses had blocked, and anyway, I know y'all don't want to hear about all that, so we'll make announcements, but they... I want to say thanks to Dr. Teresa Baston. She is at the Northeast Alabama Health Services, and she got me in where I needed to go and where I needed to be, and made sure all that worked out good. So I appreciate her for that.
She takes pretty good care of you.
She does. I just love her. She's a good doctor, and makes sure, you know, that we get what we need when we need it. So. We appreciate her for that. And also, I got some announcements. Do you have any, Mr. Oney?
Well, you know, there is a couple of things I was checking on earlier.
Okay.
And today, you know, this day in history.
Yeah, this today in history.
So do you know what happened on this day back in 2006?
That would have been 11 years ago. No.
Well, I forget the guy's name now. But he done the first tweet on Twitter.
Oh, it's only been around 11 years. Wow.
Of course, I'm thinking, well, who did he tweet, you know?
So, that's right. So who did he
tweet? Oh, I didn't say that. I don't know.
It's kind of like Alexander Graham Bell when he made his first phone call.
Made his first phone call, yeah.
He had to he called somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Don't remember who, but I know he did.
So you hear
across
about
the room.
You hear about the person that makes the call, but you didn't hear about the person that receives it. So, you know.
That's true. You forget that.
John Smith, he was the first one to receive a telephone call.
No, he wasn't.
Well, I don't know. I was just
something. It's Watson or something. No, I don't know. Anyway, our guest may know. He knows so much.
Who knows?
Our guest.
Well, we'll have to ask him about
I bet he knows who it was. We have today, our guest is going to be Mr. Anthony Clifton. He is our EMT guy from Fort Payne, from DeKalb County Emergency Management. EMT. I said EMT. Emergency Management. I think he used to be an EMT. But he'll be on in just a little bit. Did you have any other announcements?
Oh, no, go ahead.
No, do you have anything else?
No,
is it ice cream day or anything that we need to know about?
It's always ice cream day. It was ice cream day yesterday.
It was at
Dairy Queen.
Dairy Queen. Yeah. They gave away free ice cream cones.
Yeah, we didn't get one, though.
Well, I know, right? Well, that was another long story.
Yeah.
So we have lots of long stories. But we'll tell those
later.
That's
a different show.
It needs to be. We need to have our own show of my long stories.
Long stories.
Yeah. So
that's what we'll call it, long stories.
Long stories. Brought to you in part
it's a long stories. Let me tell you about
So I'm going to make important announcements right now. Then we'll do some not
so what I said maybe, wasn't important.
Maybe not so important.
Okay, go ahead.
March 23rd. This is blood drives going on. Miss Felicia Christopher from Blood Assurance. March 23rd at Northeast Alabama Community College from 10 to 3. That would be Central Time. And on March 31st at the Walmart at Fort Payne from 11:30 to 5. And I know I say this every time.
We need to go
donate blood. We haven't done that in a while.
We'll do that one of these days.
We're going to have to. I'm telling you. It's just, it's a need. It's a big need. Even if there's not, you know, we tend to want to jump in and help when there's a tragedy. But we need to do it every day because there's tragedies every day that we don't hear about. You know, there's people in the hospital and needing blood and all that, so.
Well, I don't know if I can get blood every day.
Well, no, but if you give it as regular, you know, like you can, you can give it every 6 weeks, I think, or something.
Yeah, something like that.
So, I also wanted to remind everybody that the Market on the Square is happening downtown Scottsboro, free admission, and that is Saturday, April the 8th. Do you know this is... There's only 10 more days left in this month.
This whole year is just zipping by.
And that is from 9 to 4 Central Time. So, I don't know. Hopefully, some of their local vendors maybe got in on that. I would love to go. It's crafts and vintage clothing and home decor and all kind of neat things. Shop downtown Scottsboro. Also, the Jackson County Bama Club is having their annual Roll Tide Golf Tournament May the 12th. So mark your calendars for that. That's a little ways off, but we'll talk more about that. This is when the days that the courthouse is closed.
Okay.
It's 2017 holidays. Voted on by the Jackson County Commission, and the next one we have coming up is April 24th, and you know what day that is? I just told you, didn't I?
No, but I can see it. So.
Oh, look, you can see that far? You can see it because I'm holding it up far enough,
I can read it.
Confederate Memorial Day.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what that means. We'll have to ask Matthew what. I'm assuming it's Memorial Day for Confederate soldiers. But
sounds good.
Yeah, so I don't know if they've got anything going on as far as...
Probably just a day off.
Just a day off. Also, don't forget that about the backpack program still going on up at Bryant School. Miss Marianne Rogers is over that. If you can donate to that, that's a good cause. Also, Bryant Junior High School, their PTO, will be having their golf tournament. It's their second annual golf tournament, April 22nd. So all you golfers out there, we got golf tournaments coming up. We mm-hmm. got fish. There's fishing tournament coming up. March 31st through April 2nd, so that's what, next weekend, right?
Probably.
Yeah. It's at Lake Gunnersville or Scottsboro. It's the McDonald's Big Bass Splash. And for more information, you can contact Nicole Seeley at 888-698-2591. The Chamber of Commerce is helping host this as well, so you can contact them, Miss Angie Bell. I don't have her number here handy, I don't believe, but if for you bass fishermen, there's you can either go fishing or golfing. You need a hobby, maybe. Your hobby's doing whatever I need done, isn't it?
Yes, dear.
Yeah. And it's a very good hobby. I think it's a good hobby.
Well, I'm planning on getting a little fishing in this summer.
Are you? Yeah. Okay. Here's something going on, and I don't know how many people would be interested in this, but I personally would not be. This would be the last thing I would pick to do with my life. But you can go to the... And look how much it cost. The South Pittsburgh Hospital is having their celebrity ghost hunt. And you spend the night in the hospital, and this guy, Chad Lindbergh, and I don't know him, but it says he's known for his work on The Fast and Furious, Supernatural, October Sky, da 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 da. Can go and stay in the hospital and see all these ghosts that they apparently have. Hmm. It's a sleepover event. You're permitted to sleep anywhere within the hospital. There's electricity here, and the main base areas have heat. You are required to bring an air mattress, cot, and sleeping bag. For more information, though, you can go online and search Old South Pittsburgh Hospital, South Pittsburgh, Tennessee, Celebrity Ghost Hunt. Or let's see if there's another way. I'm sure there is, but I don't see it right offhand.
We should do that.
No, we're not doing that.
See if we see any ghosts.
Would you do that? It's coming up March 20th. It's Friday, March 24th. I think it's 23rd, 24th, 25th. You can pick your day.
Wow.
Yeah, would you do that?
Well, I'd have to do it the Friday. Well, I want the fresh ghosts. I don't want the old one.
Here's www.ghosthuntusa.com. It says you can enter via the morgue area, and once you step 1 foot across the threshold, so you got to start talking scary, you will soon understand and feel the energy that still lives on at Old South Pittsburgh Hospital. So, if you're interested in that, though, that's something that you could check on. Like I said, that's not anything I would be wanting to do. April 14th, our friend Katrina Barkley is going to be live at Vintage 1889 in Fort Payne. And I really want to go. I've been wanting to go, and I'm either sick.
You missed the last time.
I know. And I really want to go. It's April 14th from 9 to 12 Eastern time that night. So if you get a chance, mark your calendars, April 14th, go see Katrina. I love her. I love her music. Love to just love her. She's a sweet, sweet person. This Thursday night, the 23rd, PTO at Bryant is having their meeting at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. And they will be nominating officers for the 2017-2018 school year. Now, I'm just going to voice my opinion here. Miss Stephanie Kirkpatrick, I think, has been president of the PTO for this past year, maybe two. She has done an awesome job with the PTO at Bryant. They have accomplished a lot. She's worked really hard, and I don't know if she, you know, by the bylaws or whatever, she probably can't be it again. I don't know that for a fact, but somebody that's willing to work. Hopefully they'll get somebody that's willing to work as hard as Stephanie has been, and I'm sure she'll help out, you know, as much as she can. You do that when you have kids in school. But she's really done an awesome job, and I appreciate her for that, even though I don't have children at Bryant or anywhere else. Well, I have children, but not in school.
Not in school.
Yeah.
We have one in school.
Yeah, she'll graduate.
I'm talking about Megan.
Well, she teaches. Yeah.
Oh, well, I'm still.
Yeah, we have one, and she's off on spring break this week.
Yeah. She's watching the show.
No, she's not watching. She's doing good to watch that grandbaby, I'm sure. I wanted to let everybody know, too, there's a special called school board meeting tomorrow, Wednesday the 22nd at 8 a.m. Central Time, be 9 o'clock Eastern Time. I don't know. I don't know why. I have some issue with this. Of course, that's my opinion. Why the school board has random times for their meetings. They're never the same time. Even the regular meetings, even if they're not special called, like in February, the regular meeting was at 8 that morning, and this month it was at 4:30. So I don't know if, you know, but I don't know how parents can know about these meetings unless they go on to the Board of Education website and look. And that's, I think, something that maybe needs to be addressed, because the agenda's not on there. This is a special called meeting for tomorrow at 8 a.m. Not sure what it's about. Like I said, the agenda's not on the website, so don't really know why they're having a special called meeting. I've heard rumors that their Paint Rock may be closing. I don't know if that's true.
They're discussing it, I think.
Yeah. So any parents out there that would like to attend, get up early in the morning and go to the school board meeting, voice your opinion. I think, and this, like I said, this is something I'd like to see changed. I think they should have their, at least their regular meetings at a set time so parents can plan for that. So maybe that's something we might see if we can put our 2 cents worth in. And I wanted to announce this, and I'm going to leave some of these here with Evan. Harvest Christian School for the Deaf is having a benefit singing and auction at North Sand Mountain High School Saturday, April 8th from 7 to 9 p.m. Eastern Time. They're having a silent auction. All the proceeds will help keep the doors open to Harvest Christian School for the Deaf. And at this school, I think, is actually in Ringgold, maybe. But we have people up on the mountain that attend, and there's some special, great, special music going to be there as Stacy Peak, Shania and Jeff Hawes, and Benny Berry and the Harvest Deaf Choir. So for more information, you can contact Cammy Green at 256-597-4263. V Peak at 256-597-2624, or Pat Jones at 256-597-2528. This is a great thing if you like some good Southern gospel music.
Yeah.
Go help them out Saturday, April the 8th from 7 to 9 at North Sand Mountain School, and it's Harvest Christian School for the Deaf. So y'all be sure and remember that. And I just wanted to real quickly, I got on Facebook before we left, and I saw where Miss Lavelle de Higdon Floyd is having a birthday today, and Mr. Mark Inman. Mark? Yes. And Melinda told him he was her number one brother.
So lucky happy for him.
I know, right? Happy birthday, Mark and Lavelda. And I'm sure there's lots of other people out there with birthdays today, but I didn't see them, so I apologize for that.
Well, if they want today, they need to be telling you that.
I know. I'm going to try to do better after tax season's over, even though I'm not doing a lot. I'm still working a lot. So, and being sick, that has not helped. And I'm talking nasally. I know, I feel like I am talking real nasally. So they're supposed to, hopefully he fixed me, but we'll see, I guess. He did get something out of my face.
Yeah, he did.
We have a container at home with a little piece of plastic, maybe?
Something, I don't know what it is.
Yeah, it's a little piece of something that he got out of my face. How it got there, we don't know.
It's a mystery.
It is a mystery. It's a mystery as to what it is. But it's our souvenir. I started to bring it and share it with Evan. I thought he might want to see it, but I declined against that. So we're going to take a commercial break, and when we come back, we're going to have Mr. Anthony Clifton, and we're going to talk a little bit about, Jackson County's under a severe thunderstorm warning right now.
If you're watching live.
If you're watching live, that's right. If you're not watching live on Tuesday, the 21st, then we're probably not. We hope we're not. But, you know, we might be then, too. You never know.
Is it a warning or a watch?
It's a watch. Okay. Yeah. And we might find out about what those definitions are, the difference, you know.
We got a man back out.
I know. He's going to explain that. He's going to talk to us a little bit about the avian flu, too, that's going on.
Okay.
So y'all be sure and hang around, and we'll be back in just a few minutes.
Have lunch or dinner at Guthrie's, home of the original golden fried chicken finger and the best chicken finger sauce in the world. Guthrie's can help you plan your family's meals or get-togethers with bucket specials every Tuesday, those delicious wings on Wednesday, and platters every day of the week. Plus, get sweet tea by the gallon. Remember, Guthrie's has a party room for small gatherings, too. Guthrie's, Highway 136 West in Trenton, home of those golden fried chicken fingers and the best chicken finger sauce in the world.
Guthrie's, not fast food, good food fast.
Delivering top-quality health care locally, we are Northeast Alabama Health Services. With 7 locations, there's one near you. Scottsboro, Section, North Sand Mountain in Higdon, Skyline, Woodville, Fife, and Fort Payne. We accept Medicare, Medicaid, and of course your private insurance. If you're unemployed, low income, or have a high copay or deductible, you may also qualify for a reduced rate office visit as low as $16. Ask about our free medication program. And ladies, you may qualify for a free or reduced rate mammogram. And cervical cancer screenings are available too. Putting your health concerns first, we're Northeast Alabama Health Services.
Citizens Tri-County Bank, the only community bank Marion Countyans will ever need. At 402 North Cedar Avenue in South Pittsburgh, 4765 Main Street in Jasper, and at 14087 Highway 28 in Whitwell. Providing the highest standard of customer services with a personal touch. Our associates can help you with personal loans, personal lines of credit, a variety of mortgage loans, and more. And we offer real-time internet banking, too. See us in South Pittsburgh, Jasper, and Whitwell today. Citizens Tri-County Bank, the only community bank Marion Countyans will ever need. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Come enjoy pizza for lunch or dinner in a family atmosphere at Stevie B's Pizza, 2200 Galt Avenue North in Fort Payne. Enjoy the super buffet and salad bar anytime, or have any of our specialty pizzas made to order and delivered right to your table. At Stevie B's in Fort Payne, we make our own dough, assuring you the best possible pizza. Book your parties at Stevie B's in Fort Payne. Plus, ask about catering and fundraisers, too. Call Stevie B's 256-979-1234 and find out more. Great pizza and a family atmosphere. Stevie B's, 2200 Galt Avenue North in Fort Payne.
Looking for a great way to change your look? You'll find the friendly professionals at A Classy Cut Salon ready to care for you. A Classy Cut Salon is in the Grove Shopping Center next to the Dollar General. We serve men and women of all ages at A Classy Cut Salon. Call 657-5607. That's 657-5607 for an appointment, or just walk right in for your next classy cut from A Classy Cut Salon in the Grove Shopping Center, Highway 11 North in Trenton.
Hi, welcome back to Sand Mountain Community Watch. We have one of our he's my favorite, one of my favorite guests, because he's so knowledgeable. He knows a little bit. You know a little bit about everything.
I'm just making it up. You understand that, right? I will give you an answer. You didn't tell me I had to tell.
Right.
Oh my gosh, I made a mistake.
You not correct in all these things you're telling me?
I try to be.
Yeah, I think you are. I'm pretty sure you are.
But I don't know.
Well, we have Mr. Anthony Clifton with us, and he's one of our regulars, and we love having him on the show. And he was telling us before the show, we were talking about, well, before we get into that, I want to know about this storm coming in. Do you know about this storm?
Well, I hadn't checked with Peachtree City, but Huntsville weather just, I mean, probably, well, it was at 3:36 Central Time, put us under a severe thunderstorm watch. And that runs for DeKalb, Jackson, okay. Madison, Marshall, and Limestone counties. I have not heard anything out of Peachtree City for Dade and this area, at least not yet.
Okay.
That will probably be an update. Usually, and of course, this is running until 10 p.m., so they'll probably do another update about 8. So if they change, it'll as it moves, they will include more counties.
Gotcha.
And
so now that's a watch.
Thunderstorm watch. Now watch what the difference are is a thunderstorm watch means that conditions are favorable.
Okay.
And so what makes thunderstorms?
Because it's hot as blazes out there.
Exactly. And what makes thunderstorms is when you get the sun heating up the ground, warm air rises, cooler air falls, and so as that warm air rises, the ground's wet, it evaporates the moisture into the air, and of course the warmer it is, the higher that air goes, the higher it goes, the more turbulent it gets up into those big winds up way up high close to the jet stream, and that is the makings for a big thunderstorm. And as these things grow, they'll get bigger and bigger. So the more daylight you have, the more ground you have, and as it comes across, they'll just swell up this time of the year. And that's what gives us those big supercells.
Okay.
Now, this is not a supercell thunderstorm line that I'm aware of, but it is. That's the thing, is you get these pop-up thunderstorms. They'll just kind of grow out of nowhere. You'll be looking in the sky, and you'll see it'll look cloudy, and then all at once it just starts getting bigger and darker and bigger and darker. And that's a big thunderstorm.
They're calling for hail, big hail, and everything in this one, I believe.
Up to golf ball size hail. Now, keep in mind, and that's one of the things that we, the terms between watches and warnings, particular thunderstorm and severe thunderstorm, for a severe thunderstorm to occur, for it to meet the criteria, it has to have winds of 58 miles an hour.
Oh.
That's 50 knots. Knots, as in air knots, not.
My mama used to say,
not. That's right. As Jethro Goldine would say. I learned that. I've had schooling through the sixth grade in DeKalb County, by the way. This is a product of DeKalb County School.
Woohoo!
But
Jackson County right here, folks.
But it's a 50-knot wind, which is 58 miles an hour. That is the criteria for a severe thunderstorm. Okay, so once the winds hit 58 miles an hour, that's when the weather, and it has to have rain and hail. So those are the three things that set off a severe thunderstorm warning. Okay?
Okay.
So what it's doing is it's saying right now, the conditions are right that you could see between now and 10 o'clock tonight, you could see a big storm with rain, winds of upwards of 58 miles an hour, and hail.
Oh.
And so.
But lightning's not a factor.
Lightning is not a factor. Everybody calls us and they're like, oh, Lord, there's lightning everywhere.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Lightning is not a factor when it comes to the severity of a thunderstorm.
To me, that's worse.
Well, let's talk to the Weather Service. I don't make the rules.
Just the messenger.
And that's what a lot of people, we have, especially like with Alert DeKalb, our telephone warning system, our mass notification system. We signed everybody up originally when we got the system. We put everybody to be alerted for a severe thunderstorm warning or a tornado warning. Because those are polygon-based, meaning that when you see that little triangle on TV, that's the polygon that says, the weatherman says, and here, it'll be, it's going through these towns in the next 10 minutes. That's a polygon. And that's when it calls you. Now, a watch, like usually watches are countywide, all right? So you get a watch for DeKalb County. Then you start getting warnings based on the polygon. So when you hear
warnings are worse than watches.
Correct.
And we're warning. Under a warning already?
No, we're under a watch.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Okay.
Now, they will. That's the next step up is a severe thunderstorm warning.
Okay.
So whenever you get the hail, the wind, and the rain all together, they will set off a severe thunderstorm warning. Now, what that is, you got to keep in mind, like I said, a lot of people got aggravated with us because we set off the system for a severe thunderstorm warning. Now, the criteria for a severe thunderstorm can be worse than a tornado. All right. So, in other words, there are in a severe thunderstorm, you can have winds upwards of 110 miles an hour. Straight line winds, just winds. Okay.
It's not spinning winds.
Okay. It's straight line winds.
Gotcha.
110 miles an hour. Well, an F0 tornado is 60 miles an hour. Twisting winds.
Oh.
Okay. An F1 is 80 miles an hour. So everybody, you know, they kind of get aggravated at us for making a big deal out of a severe thunderstorm. Well, believe it or not, there's actually more property damage that's done in our area from severe thunderstorms than are smaller tornadoes.
Oh. So if somebody, and that goes back to any time there's damage, right?
Always call us. If there's damage, there's a lot of times you can't tell the difference between straight line wind damage or tornado damage. And because, you know, what'll happen is it depends on the trees. Like if you get trees that you say, well, this tree's twisted. Well, the thing about it is it depends. Does it have leaves on it or no leaves? So if it's in the springtime before the leaves pop out, like a big oak tree, and it's twisted, that's probably a sign that it could have been a tornado. But in the summertime or later spring, once the leaves get out, just a good strong wind will, you know, can cause it to give it that twisting motion. So it's not real easy to tell.
Do y'all do that?
What we do, and that's one of the things, is you call the local. So tonight, all right, it's 9:30, and you're at home, and the wind blows away your lawnmower shed, or blows the top off your hay barn, or rolls over your RV.
It blows my wreath off my door.
Blows a wreath off your door, whatever it may be.
You want to know about that?
For you, yes.
Thank you.
Everybody else, no. I don't want to know about the wreath. So see, I will take her call.
I will call you and say, my wreath blew off my door.
Your wreath blew off the door. That is a sure sign of the apocalypse, though. You got to remember that, too.
That's right. Oh, what will we do?
Oh, what will we do? But when that happens, call us, because we will have to get the National Weather Service out. They come out.
Okay.
They do a survey, and they have certain criteria that they go by, and they will tell us, they will rate it on the EF scale, EF 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
If it's 5, you kind of know that.
Yeah.
But they don't take
it. It sounded like a freight train, right?
Yeah. And, well, I heard the chickens hitting the side of the trailer, and I know it is a tornado. You know?
I want you to know. Now, really, what was it? A couple of weeks ago, it got bad, and it was real windy. And I was laying in the bed, and I thought, it's real windy. I need to get up. And I thought, I'm too tired. And then I thought, I think I hear a train. You know, it sounded like a train. And I'm like, oh, surely not. I just laid there. I thought,
Well, the question of it is you know, the real sign of it is there railroad tracks anywhere near? Okay? So if you're living in a valley where there's railroad tracks, you hear a train, that's okay. But if you happen to live on Sand Mountain where there ain't no railroad tracks, you hear a train, that might be a sign
indicator
that you want to get up.
Get out of the bed.
Yeah, it could be. Or not. Doesn't matter.
It's like, I'm too lazy to move.
Exactly. And we understand that. Okay? And, of course, that's the thing, darling. The stupid die first. Remember that, okay?
Well, I say, we live right across from the school, and so there's storm shelters right there. I may have told you this already.
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so I can see the storm shelters. Do we go there?
It ain't going to happen to us. Understand that.
It
will not happen to us.
So I told my niece, I said, if anything ever happens, because she was like, you need to go get in that storm shelter. And I said, if anything ever happens, I said, I want the funeral home people to pull my
lip up and pretend I had a stroke. So people would think I was just, I had a stroke and couldn't get over that.
Exactly. We'll make sure that
happens. Yeah, I know.
Okay. We will tell that story repeatedly. That will die in infamy right there. Poor thing, she was, you stand over in the cabin, don't she look good?
Don't she look good with that?
But she's had a stroke. Her face is a little bit drawn. And then the tornado ran over.
Okay. The tornado. She had the stroke, and then 3 seconds later, the tornado hit.
That's right. Exactly. Exactly. Why did you? I tried. I drugged her out, grabbed her by the leg, and tried to get her out.
Oh, Lord.
No. But yes, you might want to think about it.
Yeah.
And the other thing a lot of folks don't realize is that warnings are not instant, okay? Because tornadoes have to start somewhere.
Yeah.
And around here, and it's my belief, and there's some matter of fact, that's something else we want to tell you while I'm thinking about it before I forget it. When you see these weird little weather-looking stations sitting out in a pasture or beside a road, leave them alone.
Oh.
Okay. We've got some scientists in DeKalb in Jackson County. I know of. I don't know about over in Georgia, but I do know in working out of the Huntsville Weather Office. They're doing some scientific measuring. They're trying to catch storms because the belief is, and of course I've said this for years, that because of the way Sand Mountain is and it's flat, it's a plateau, when the wind hits it, it creates an updraft, and especially when you get that as hot as it is out today,
mm-hmm.
and you get that updraft going already, and when that storm hits the side of the mountain and you got that real strong updraft, I think that's where it spins them up at.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the reason we get right across kind of this northern section of northeast Alabama, coming out of Jackson County, across the river, across Sand Mountain, and mm-hmm. on into Georgia. That's one of the things that I believe causes that.
Right.
Scientists are actually trying to prove that theory now. So if you see
that, it picks up moisture from the river.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we have the river on this side.
Right.
So.
And that makes it that much worse,
yeah.
I believe. Now,
yeah.
Again, we're trying to get science to prove that, but we've got a group. It's a group working together from Texas A&M and Oklahoma State and Ohio State, I believe, that are actually here working with that. So if you see odd little instruments setting out in a storm, it's okay.
Okay.
You know, and that's what it is.
So do they put them out? Are they out there all the time?
Well, no. What they do is they'll do, like right now, we've got a prediction, conditions are right, and so they'll run, put them out.
Okay.
And then they'll go back tomorrow and pick them up and download the readings and,
and
all that.
Kind of like on that tornado movie.
On the tornado movie, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, I hated about him dying.
Yeah.
That was a good movie.
Yep.
Do we need to take a break? I figured. So we're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about... Is that thunder?
No, I think that was a Harley. I don't...
That was a truck.
Truck or a motorcycle. Or could be thunder. Run!
We'll be back in a minute, folks.
Innovation and quality, two things you don't normally hear about in a recruitment ad, but you'll hear a lot about innovation and quality when you join the team at Vanguard National Trailer. Vanguard is an industry leader in the production of dry van trailers and composite plate trailers.
And right now, Vanguard National Trailer is hiring energetic and hardworking team members to be assemblers and welders, as well as industrial maintenance for first shift openings.
And you'll work a full 40-hour week in 4 days, which means three-day weekends, and overtime is available. Working at Vanguard National Trailer has other great benefits too, like paid holidays, paid vacation, medical, dental, vision, and life insurance, plus a 401k plan.
Full-time work, three-day weekends, available overtime, and great benefits. That's Vanguard National Trailer.
Fill out your application today. Vanguard National Trailer is an equal opportunity employer.
Applying person today. Starting pay $10 to $14 an hour, depending on position. Vanguard National Trailer Corporation, Highway 11 North, turn beside the Primary Healthcare Center on Vanguard Drive.
I'm your tailgate grill. Your buddy was in such a rush to get into the game, he didn't quite put me out. I see you bought the industrial-sized bottle of lighter fluid. Smart.
And if you got cut-rate insurance, you could be paying for this yourself. So get an Allstate agent and be better protected from mayhem. Like me.
There's an Allstate agent right here in your community.
The Moore family name has built a legacy of trust, compassion, and peace of mind by standing with families during time of loss. Now in our 70th year, the Moore family commitment grows even stronger, from affordable traditional services to cremation. Our experienced staff stands ready to follow through on you and your family's wishes. Since 1945, the Moore family of funeral homes, North Sand Mountain and Trenton, always dedicated to those we serve.
Get it hot and ready right now at Little Caesars, Highway 136 West in Trenton and 411 Kimball Crossing in Kimball. Get that hot and ready pepperoni or cheese pizza for just $5. How about deep, deep dish pizza, just $8. The new pretzel crust pizza, just $6. 10-piece Italian cheese bread, just $4. The three meat treat, just $8. And make sure you ask about the hot and ready meal deal.
Pizza, pizza.
Little Caesars, two locations to serve you, Highway 136 West in Trenton and 411 Kimball Crossing in Kimball.
Welcome back to Sand Mountain Community Watch. We're just sitting here watching it storm. No, not really. It's not storming yet. And it might not. Be sure and take precaution in case it does.
Well, you know, it's always better to be
safe than sorry.
Overly prepared than, you know, than not.
Yeah.
But what I was talking about a while ago with the difference between the thunderstorm warnings and the tornado warnings, severe thunderstorms can do a lot of damage, and particularly when it comes to hail. I know, what was it, 2 weeks ago up towards your way, y'all got some tennis ball size hail. I mean, there was
maybe that's what I heard instead of the freight train.
Might not have been a train, it might have been a hail. That's right.
So, I just understand lightning not being a factor.
But nope, lightning's not a factor.
In anything. It scares the blazes out of me. Lightning, it scares me a lot worse than wind.
Well,
Maybe I'm not.
I can see you being scared of. I mean, lightning is a real danger. People don't realize how many folks, and I can't quote you how many people die every year from lightning, but it is more than die from wind. You know, in other words, more people are seriously injured by lightning strikes than they are by being blown away.
Yeah.
And so, yes, it's definitely something to be scared of.
And you know what I think it is? I think that, I don't know why. This is just weird. Probably, but to me, God controls lightning.
No. But of course, he don't control wind, right?
No, he does. Okay, but okay. There's like factors, you know, like weather affects the wind. But no, it's just like God sitting just there shooting. That's right. And it's like he's
going to
get me. A vengeful,
wrathful God, yes.
You know. So, no.
That's lightning we heard, so. I'm sorry. I shouldn't do that.
But no, I mean that. You know, it's almost like lightning's only going to strike where God wants it. I mean, and I know that's not. Lord, forgive me. And I know that's not right. But you know, that's kind of
well,
like.
Well, it does seem like it. Does.
I know it does.
If you're a sinner, you're scared of lightning. Remember that. Okay, God is looking specifically for you. Right? And if you live anywhere near North Sand Mountain School, be particularly
Watch, don't
careful.
Don't get close
Do
to
not.
Me.
Exactly. Because we know who he's on.
No, I'm scared of lightning.
Okay, all right, very good.
My mama used to say, like, when it would lightning, don't get under the light fixture. Mm-hmm. Is it still that? And don't get on the phone, and don't get near the window. I mean, you just had to kind of.
Well,
mama scared me.
Well, lightning can strike inside a house. I mean, once it hits the house, it can run through the wiring, and a lot of the older people. Particularly my grandmother's house used to get hit by lightning every time a storm came through, and she was scared to death of the telephone because, of course, in those days, the telephones were connected with copper wire.
Yeah, yeah.
And even at that, they had metal pipes that ran through. You know, my grandmother would say, stay away from the bathtub because
yeah.
It was a cast iron bathtub with galvanized mm-hmm. metal pipes running to it. Stay away from the sink.
Don't get near the sink. You just had to stand in the middle of the
Exactly. Hall. You were had to camp out somewhere where there's nothing there. Of course, they had tin roofs, too.
Yeah.
But so lightning, yes, can strike a house. And once it hits the wiring, you know, you can get hit inside a house. But in those days, you know, they had the big metal spring beds.
Oh,
lots
yeah.
of metal, lots of conductive stuff inside the house. You know, the chances of you getting lightning struck by a cell phone, not as good. Because you actually would have to be outside and get hit. But there are cases where you can get lots of cars are struck by lightning, believe
it
or not.
I thought cars were safe because of the rubber wheels.
They are. Doesn't keep them from getting struck by lightning.
Right.
And what it'll do is it'll fry the electrical system. It'll mess up the radio and the stereo and your computer. But like airplanes get hit all the time, but they're not grounded. You know, so they just get hit, and it kind of goes in one side and right out the other because there's nothing that's not grounded to it.
Oh, you know what? I would just die if I was on a plane and it got... I would just die right there.
I probably would, too. I've never been in an airplane.
Ever?
I've been once, twice. But I hate to fly.
Not when it's lightning.
I've flown through a thunderstorm, and that's why I don't like to fly.
Oh, yeah.
But lightning is extremely dangerous, and especially when you're out in an open area. But, you know, you get these guys that are golfers, and they'll golf right. I've seen them golf right through thunderstorms. So, you know, they got a big metal stick in their hand, and they poke it up in the air, you know, and they're... Well, that's the sharpest knife in the drawer. So we wonder why, you know, they got hit.
Yeah. Maybe they're sinners.
They could be. They could be.
Has nothing to do with sticking that metal pole up
exactly.
there. It's just their sinners.
Just their sinners, right.
God's like, bing!
Don't golf on Sunday, right?
Oh, Lord. But, Jimmy's over there shaking his head. Bless his heart.
We're going to be in trouble for this.
I know.
You understand
that,
right? The FCC is probably watching us right now. But
not to mention the preachers.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh,
it's
man.
Not my show. Remember that. It's letters go to her.
Evan Stone. Send
Evan
him to Evan.
Stone, yes. He gets all the hate mail.
Oh, man.
But when you, again, it is tornado season, and... what we want you to do is the biggest thing is to be prepared, have a plan, make sure you know what your plan is. Again, if you live in a mobile home, you know, don't wait until the tornado warning gets here to say, hey, what you think we ought to do now? I don't know. Let's call somebody. Have a plan. Know what you're going to do. And most importantly, know that if your plan is to go to the storm shelter, make sure the storm shelter is open. Believe it or not, we get hundreds of calls from people who say, well, I went to the storm shelter and it was locked. Or I went to the church to get in the basement and it was locked.
Yeah.
Make sure if you're going to the church, the church knows it. Make sure that if you're going to the storm shelter, that the city knows it.
Yeah.
Or the school or whoever happens to own the storm shelter. Whatever your plan is, test
See,
it.
See, and I don't know. That's something we need to... I'll need to talk to Matthew about that next week. We don't know who has the key, you know, across the road. Mm-hmm. And so I can look and see, I guess, but...
And again, some shelters don't stay locked. Some of them are open all the time because it's just a big metal building and there's very little you can hurt.
Yeah.
But that's something you need to do. Make sure whatever your plan is that you...
And have a plan.
Right. That you've got a plan and kind of know, at least in the back of your mind, what you're going to do. The other thing is have somebody that you can call that don't live here. And what I mean by that is if for some reason you are separated from your family, from your loved ones, mom's at work, dad's at work, kids are at home after school, storm comes, and now we can't get in touch with each other because what's going to happen?
Phones are going
to jam. Mm-hmm. The thing about it is when we have a storm, a cell phone tower will only carry about 200 phone calls at a time. And
I
so,
didn't know that.
And that's the deal is... If all the phones, if everybody picks up the phone at the same time, it just jams the system up and nobody gets to talk.
Right.
And that's why text messaging works so much better because text message move in digital packets. In other words, it's like a tiny little digital envelope that just pops through. That's why you can get a text through when you can't get voice through. So, but the best thing to do is if you're concerned about it, like I say, mom's at work, dad's at work, kids are at home. Let everybody call grandma who lives two towns over.
Right.
Because if they call her, chances are her phones are not messed up. So if you can get in touch with her, then she can keep trying the kids. You know, dad can keep trying the kids or call her. And that way you've got somebody else that's not in the affected area. The other thing to do is to tell grandma if the storm hits here, don't call us here. Okay, because we're all going to call Aunt Sue.
Mm-hmm.
She don't live nowhere around us because what happens is everybody's grandma is trying to call in, which makes the congestion that much worse. So if you can just text Aunt Susie and let Aunt Susie call everybody else to let them know you're okay. So a communications plan is real important.
And we don't know, but I bet nobody has that.
No.
No. You don't have that either, do you?
Of course I do.
Do you really? No. Yeah.
I am the EMA director. What kind of question is that to ask? No, we just haphazardly call. Yeah.
Text, where you at? Are you all right?
Are you okay?
Are you okay?
No, actually, I hope all of my family are with me. I try to bring them to work if I can with me, so I don't have to worry about them. But that's our plan.
Yeah.
Is because I have to work. I'm in the basement, and I like to know where I'm at. And if I don't, we do. You know, I do call my wife and say, get the kids and go to the storm shelter.
Uh-huh. So do y'all have your personal storm shelter?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's a little one. I mean, it's just a single family in-ground shelter outside that we built after the storm of 2013. But, everybody needs to have a plan.
Yeah.
And then know the plan. But there again, it's even if you got a plan, one of the toughest things that I have found is trying to get the dog into the storm shelter. And people don't think about that. You know, it's thundering, it's lightning, it's raining.
It's not going to go out
the
there.
The train is headed your way, and you've got, you know, 150 pounds bloodhound. That's what we've got.
Yeah.
He's not going in the storm shelter. And my wife says, well, I'm not going in the storm shelter. And I say, well, then both of you are going to die. You know, that's just all there is to it. You know.
So what do you do about getting the dog in?
I let her deal with it. I say let the dog go.
Yeah.
But she won't have it.
Yeah.
That one's yet to be fussed out. And I got a feeling it's coming tonight because she's watching this.
Oh, Lord. I know I'm going to get in trouble for saying that I'm a sinner and God's going to strike me. We're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, we're going to figure all this out. So y'all stick around. We'll be right back.
It's time to stock up on Uncle Lars Outpost Complete Meals with dozens of choices. Try our gluten-free barbecue chicken and rice, or our hearty turkey stew, or choose our chuck wagon stew with long grain rice. All of our meals are ready to feed your entire family with no modified ingredients, no colors, no MSG, no dyes, and no preservatives. Also, try our snacks and popcorn along with our flavored waters. Visit our two locations in Trenton, 12270 South Main inside Peddlers, on Main and Highway 136 West inside Cabins to Castles, or buy online at UncleLarsOutpost.com.
It's another spring planting season at Glass Farm Nursery. Glass Farm Nursery, 4 miles south of Trenton on Highway 11, is your tree and shrub headquarters for spring. They've been sprucing up yards for generations, and they're now ready for you this year. Glass Farm Nursery open Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. and Saturday 8 a.m. till 2 p.m. For all of your lawn, gardening, flowers, and shrubbery needs, look no further than Glass Farm Nursery. Now open for spring, 4 miles south of Trenton on Highway 11. Glass Farm Nursery.
The Rising Fawn Baptist Church Choir proudly presents our 2017 Easter Concert. Join us for performances on Saturday, April the 8th, and Sunday, April the 9th. Both performances will be at 7 o'clock in the evening. Come and enjoy and help us celebrate this wonderful season. It's the annual Easter Concert with the Rising Fawn Baptist Church Choir, Saturday, April the 8th, Sunday, April the 9th, at 7 o'clock each evening, located at 4411 Highway 11 South, Rising Fawn.
Spring is just around the corner, and your lawn care and decisions about lawn care are soon to be on the horizon. Let me tell you about a good, dependable lawn care service that's ready to provide you honest, dependable lawn care and at a reasonable price. Holman's Lawn Care is ready to maintain your yard this spring. Call Denny Holman at 423-280-6495. Denny will be happy to provide you references and a free estimate. From residential to commercial, each lawn will be done with their personal commitment. Don't put your lawn care decision off any longer. Call Holman's Lawn Care, 423-280-6495.
Now open at Ider, it's buy for less. Catalog returns, overstock, chef pulls, everything from furniture, kitchen accessories, tools, baby items and clothes, outdoor equipment, and hunting gear. You'll find it at buy for less. Just like our name suggests, you can buy for less at buy for less. We're just south of the Ider four-way stop on Alabama Highway 75. Open Wednesday through Friday, 10 to 4 Central, 11 to 5 Eastern. Saturday, we're open 9 to 1 Central, 10 to 2 Eastern Time. It's buy for less.
Hey, we're blah, blah, blah. Welcome back to Sand Mountain Community Watch.
Remember that stroke?
That's right. It's probably real. Oh, Lord. You're going to think of that when I'm laying in my casket.
I am. I am. And I'm going to come and say, don't you look good.
Don't you? Do. Please do. But now, see, they pick on me. Jimmy and Evan pick on me because I want a bunch of songs played. And they're like, nobody's got time for that.
No, we don't want to hear that.
No, I won't. There's like 16 songs I won't play at my funeral. I don't want to be preaching or talking. That's because I'm probably going to get struck by lightning.
Exactly. There'll be nothing left.
I'll be cremated and at the same time.
They'll just sweep you up, put you in a fruit jar, and sing over you, I guess. I don't know.
Oh, Lord.
But.
Oh, man. But anyway.
On a serious note.
Well, that was serious. wait, I'm gonna. We don't have but like 10 minutes, so I don't think we have a whole lot of time to get into this. But the bird flu, avian bird flu.
Oh, we were talking about the bird flu has been in the news over at Taco Bell last weekend. The USDA found a bird that was infected with avian flu. Avian flu. A lot of people have heard of it, but really don't understand what it is. One of the big concerns with it is the fact that it's the flu in birds. Does the same thing to birds that it does to people. It makes them sick and they die. And you say, well, what's the big deal? Well, number one, the big deal is you can destroy entire flocks of chickens in a matter of literally hours.
It's real contagious.
It's highly contagious. And the good news is it's not highly contagious to people. It very rarely goes from person or from bird to person, but it goes from bird to bird to bird very easily. And the problem of it is migratory birds, when they migrate, they bring things in from other countries and other places. Like there are birds who fly from here to nest in South America and then come back. As they do, they can spread the flu just like we spread people flu.
Mm-hmm.
The thing about it is if this ever got loose in the community, the big concern, now that's thunder.
Ooh, it's shaking the thing over there.
If you get the bird flu loose in the commercial chicken population, it could do irreparable damage economically.
Now, Taco Bell was just like a random bird that somebody was selling, like a chicken or something.
And so now it is the State Department of Agriculture, at least in Alabama, and if not the USDA, it may be the U.S. Department of Agriculture, has banned the transportation and sale of non-commercial birds, residential flocks. And so what that means is you don't want to go to Taco Bell, you don't want to go to First Monday, you don't want to go to Collinsville Trade Day or Mountaintop, wherever you go. One, they will confiscate your animals, mm-hmm. and two, you can be fined for that. So until they get that quarantine stopped, the problem of it is they've killed at least one, it's called depopulated, killed. They didn't kill it, they depopulated.
Oh!
At least 15,000 chickens, a commercial chicken house in Limestone County. They depopulated a residential flock of about 25 birds in Madison County. Now, they found these in Jackson County, and it was not a chicken, it was a guinea, actually.
Oh.
In Jackson County.
Oh.
But now they begin to find the flu in Kentucky and Tennessee.
Oh.
So we're looking at things that could be more widespread. Again, folks say that's not a big deal. Well, it's a big deal if you're a chicken farmer.
Yeah.
It's a big deal if you eat chicken. Now, don't run out there and be hysterical about not eating chicken. It's kind of like salmonella and things that you normally have to be concerned with chicken. Avian flu is killed easily with heat, so when you cook your chicken,
just cook it.
You're good.
Mm-hmm.
The thing about it is, it can be passed from humans through contact with chicken excrement.
Mm-hmm.
There's your word. Excrement.
That's DeKalb County coming up.
Exactly. But you know, if you walk and say somebody has a residential flock and one of the chickens are sick and you walk and get it on your shoes and then walk in the floor and the baby's in the floor, I mean, yes, it is possible to transmit the flu to people. Thank goodness that hadn't happened. Now this is my understanding is this is H5N9, which is not as strong a strain as the avian flu in China that's killed all the people. The avian flu that's going on in China.
Has people died in China from it?
160 since October.
Oh, I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. Oh.
And that's the problem. Because the real risk is that once the flu, if you ever get a situation where a person has human flu, plain old influenza A or B, just human influenza, and they happen to get avian flu, and those viruses get together and mingle their DNA, and it becomes transferable human to human, we could wind up with a worldwide pandemic. I mean, we're talking about things that we hadn't seen since the Spanish flu of 1918. Killed 50 million people, killed more people than the bubonic plague did in the 12th century.
Why do I not know that? I mean,
because you went to school at Bryant, probably. I mean, North Sand Mountain.
That's true.
DeKalb County, Jackson County. Okay. But the pandemic of 1918-1919 killed a third of the planet's population before it ended after World War I. And that's what's going to get us next. It's not going to be, you know, I mean, yes, we can worry about lightning and we can worry about tornadoes and we can worry about the Al-Qaeda's and the terrorists and the nuclear weapons, but what's going to get you is a bug. I mean, that's the way it works. The plague did it to us. The Spanish flu did it to us. Swine flu. I mean, do you realize how many people in this country die every year from, guess how many people die in the United States from the flu? And I'm talking about plain old people flu.
That actually die from the flu?
Mm-hmm.
2,000.
According to the CDC, the low side is 12,000 people and the high side is 53,000 people.
You're kidding.
Mm-hmm. That's what the CDC says. Read it right there on my little thing.
Really?
Up to 53,000 people died in 2011-2012. That's the last statistics that I could find that they actually did the mortality studies. And that was 2012. And so you go back to the H1N1, the swine flu epidemic of 2009. That killed 36,000 people in this country. 36,000 people died from the swine flu. And right now we are in the midst of an epidemic.
So do you get a flu shot?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
Every year. This time.
Well, that's part of the problem is the people who make the flu shot have to work for next year. So right now they're working on the flu for next year. That was the problem with the swine flu. The H1N1 was not covered by the flu shot that they actually put out. That's what happened this year. The flu that we've got right now, even if you had a flu shot, you're not covered.
Because there
are different strains of flu, and you're going to hear words like H1N1, that's swine flu. H7N7 is the avian flu that's going on in China. H7N9 is the avian flu we've got in the birds right now. So different strains of flu have different things.
So like, if someone has strand A and strand B, is that did the shot that they made for it, did it cover that?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And so just plain old, but there again, just because you've got the vaccine does not necessarily mean you can't get it. It just lessens your chances. So, what's going to get us as a species, as a people, is a bug.
So how many years difference was there between the bubonic plague and the Spanish?
The bubonic plague was in 1351 and the Spanish flu was in 1918. So what is that, 500 years?
Okay. Well, I'm just hoping I can
that's the problem with, and that's what a lot of people believe. When you start throwing antibiotics at everything, antibiotics makes bugs resistant to medicine.
Right.
And so, but we'll have to have a more in-depth discussion.
Yeah.
And talk about the flu.
You'll be back next month.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. All right. And hopefully it'll be on the second instead of the third Tuesday. I got you messed up because of all this. But anyway, thank y'all for tuning in. Thank you, Mr. Clifton. I appreciate it as always.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
I will sign you at your funeral.
Okay.
Plan on, look forward to that.
Please don't. I mean, don't look forward to it. But you sing, but just don't look forward to it.
Oh, trust me, you don't want me to sing.
Thank y'all so much for tuning in. Don't forget all your announcements, and we'll see you next week. I think Matthew will be here next week. So we'll see you then. Thanks so much.